Welcome to behind the scenes of La Fontana. Here we have our famous Ossobucos. These are considered one of the finer meats in the Italian restaurants. These Ossobucos are 3-inch cut, center cut from the shank of the cow. If anybody knows what the shank is, it's part of your leg, from your kneecap down to your ankles. These are beautiful Ossobucos, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and pre-cook them, and then we're going to put them in a sous vide and cook them for 16 hours. That's 16 long hours. So that means I leave them here tonight, and tomorrow, say 1 o'clock in the afternoon, I come back and they're fully cooked. This is the machine that we're using, a state-of-the-art. This is a rational self-cooking center. With this machine here, we can do basically anything. We're gonna pull out the rack. And this is the rack that we're going to put the Ossobucos in once we season them. It's a process that we take into consideration as far as the way we cook at the Fontana. Everything's from scratch. We don't play games when it comes to how we want to cook and how we want to prepare the food. Everything we do is fresh. It takes time. That's why the flavors, you're going to feel the flavors, okay? So here are the Ossobucos. And what we're basically going to do right now is just kind of season them with pepper, salt, and a little bit of olive oil. And then we're going to go ahead and put them in the machine, which is the oven. And that oven is going to seal all the juices in. And what I mean by seal, it'll give it a nice color on the outside, but it'll still be raw on the inside. And then we'll put them in cryovac bags, season it with rosemary and garlic, and then we're going to let it cook for 16 hours. Now, this is just one of the beginning of the process that we do here at the Fontana. We're doing this every week because these go like hot fire. As soon as we have this on our menu, we started making more and more as we went. So it's a good thing. So here we go. We already seasoned it with our pepper. And then we're going to go ahead and season it with some salt. I like to use kosher salt. Kosher salt is a little bit more on the grimy side. It has more flavor than idolized salt. Idolized salt is really, really, really not good for your health. But as you can see, I'm being generous because I'm gonna season both sides. I'm not just putting it on one side. You're gonna see how I now give it a full rub and let all the flavors go in through the marrow bone, just all the way around the whole piece of meat. So now that I finished putting the salt, I'm gonna go ahead and add 100% pure olive oil. And the reason why I wanna put the 100% pure olive oil is because it has a better bold flavor than just using corn oil, vegetable oil, peanut oil, but olive oil is the best to seal in the flavors that I want. So now I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of lightly pour some olive oil on it, and then I'm gonna go ahead and give it a nice rub. So here I am just putting this olive oil all over this. And as you can see, that I'm going to be using these racks so the juices can fall on top of the other one, and then the other one releases the juices on the other one, and so on and so on. So once I got the olive oil on, I'm gonna go ahead and start rubbing them down, and you'll see. I'll take the first one, kind of pat it, and then kind of just rub it. And the reason why I'm doing that is so everything is coated. So that way when I seal it inside the oven at a temperature of 500 degrees, it's just gonna seal all the juices, but give it a nice seasoned crust. That's what I'm looking for, the crust. Remember, it's gonna be cooking for 16 hours. That's a lot of hours. But it's slow cooked at 170 Celsius. So what does that mean? It's really, 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 really slowly cooking through the heat. And when it's finished, it comes right off the bone. That's exactly what I want. So what we're doing now is just basically seasoning it. We'll seal it, and then you'll see the finished product when I'm done with it. Right now we're going through the process of what I do every single week, just so you can have a beautiful ossobuco on your plate. Mamma mia, this is beautiful. Forget about it. Yep, I love what I do. So as you can see, look how beautiful that is seasoned. You're saying, wow, that's a lot of salt and pepper. But believe it or not, it's gonna sweat it all out. And you still get the flavor of the salt and pepper, but not as intense. It looks like a lot right now, but it's really not. And once I season all these, I'm gonna go ahead and load them into the rack. And then we're gonna see how I do this. And the finished product, well, obviously you'll see it when it's in the saute pan cooking at the restaurant. Yeah, we're almost there. Nice and seasoned. Now the ossobuco used to be considered a peasant food in Italy. It was so cheap that they were actually giving away this meat. It was like nobody really wanted to buy it. Nobody knew how to cook it. But as time goes on, just like the filet mignon in the 1970s, you could pay $100 for a filet mignon. Now you can go to a restaurant and get a filet mignon for $25. Where the ossobuco was the most cheapest meat that you could possibly get in the meat market, is now one of the most expensive meats in the meat market. But that's history. This is the present. I do know a lot about history with culinary arts. So these are things that kind of make me wonder, you know? Here's a filet mignon in the 70s. Paid $125 for that. But now you can get a filet mignon for $25. How times have changed. Okay, so now I seasoned everything, as you can see. And now I'm gonna go ahead and load it up into my rack. And you'll see that I'm gonna go ahead and seal it. So I'm gonna lift up these racks, and I'm gonna go ahead and start putting them like a baker's rack. Right in there. I have a pan down here to pick up all the drippings. So, as I load them, it takes about 20 minutes for it to seal completely. As I load up this last one, we'll go into the machine and set it. Put this one up on top. And as you can see, everything that drips from here will drip to here, drip to here, drip to here, final drip. But all that flavor is being combined together. So go ahead, I'm gonna go ahead and load it up into my super oven, so to speak, to my Rational self-cooking center. Because this oven here can do miracles. So you can cook a chicken under 40 minutes. So there's our ossobuco, nice, ready to go. So now I got everything programmed here. You can cook anything from a whole loin of beef, ossobuco, chicken. Everything is cooked either sous vide, fire roasted, or whatever the case is. Today we're gonna do ossobuco and sellado. That means sealed ossobuco. So I'm gonna go ahead and press this button. Automatically it's gonna give me the degrees of 260 Celsius, and it's already heating up. As you can see, I just seared the ossobucos, and I'm putting them in a special bag, which is called a cryovac bag. What does this cryovac bag does? Once I got the ossobuco in the bag, I go ahead and add my herbs and some garlic. And to give you an idea of what I'm doing, I'm just going to seal that. All the air is going to be released out of this bag. So I'm going to go ahead and apply it. As you can see, I have two ossobucos there. And then I'm going to go ahead and close it. And automatically, it's vacuuming me all the air that's inside that bag, releasing some gas, sealing it, and then I go ahead and stack them back on the rack. As you can see, they're perfectly cryovac'd. I put them back on the rack, and then I stick them back in there and cook them for another 16 hours. That 16 hours we'll be sleeping, and these ossobucos will be cooking again. So that's basically it. So tomorrow what we're going to do is, once the 16 hours are done, we're going to go ahead and pull them out, and then we'll finish them in a demi sauce at the restaurant. So I thank you for sharing with us and spending some time with us. This is La Fontana. This is the way we cook our ossobuco. We put pride, joy, and love into our food. So I'll see you soon. Okay, so we finished the process of cooking the ossobuco 16 hours overnight. Now I'm going to show you the finished product. So I'm going to go ahead, if you come a little closer, we have a simple vegetable stock or a chicken stock. And here we have the ossobuco that I cryovac'd and I cooked for 16 hours. As you can see, there's no air inside, so everything is sealed. Imagine 16 hours is already done. All I got to do is warm it up. So I'm going to go ahead and open that. So I'm going to go ahead and open this pair of scissors or knife. Just kind of want to tear that all open. And the ossobuco is in its entirety. Still has the garlic, the rosemary, a little bit of gelatin. That gelatin is going to pick up flavor as the ossobuco cooks. Well, we're not really cooking it. What we're doing is warming it up. So we're going to go ahead and just leave that in there until this sauce is reduced halfway. Constantly, you want to just kind of like bring it back to life. You go ahead and start adding the juice to it. It'll easily come to life in a few minutes. Remember, we're not cooking it. We're just warming it up to the temperature that we need, because the meat's already cooked all the way straight through. So I'm gonna go ahead and cover this so I can go ahead and speed up the process a little bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and cover it for, like, let's say about 5 minutes. Beautiful ossobuco. Look how beautiful that looks. Look at that juice. Now we're going to go ahead and plate it. Now we're going to plate our ossobuco right now. So let's go over here. So here's our ossobuco that's been cooking for 16 hours. I'm going to go ahead and lift it up off the pan. Place it right in the middle of the plate. You can see all the juices. All that juice that it accumulated. Nice, thick, heavy-duty demi is what we call it here in the restaurant. Now look, we just kind of like drizzle it on. Look how beautiful that looks. And then we're going to garnish the plate very so often slightly. Add some color to it. And this is our ossobuco a la Fontana. So if you remember, we braised it for 20 minutes. Then we cooked it for another 16 hours overnight. And then all we have to do is kind of bring it back to life. And this is our ossobuco. Beautiful. Thank you very much for participating in this little study. Thank you. Forget about it.